From now onward, to simplify, we'll just replace J omega with S, so we don't have to write J all the time. So this is another technique of further simplifying. Okay, let's do another example. In this example, we have to find the transfer function V naught over I naught, and we need to find its zeros and poles. So these are the two parts. So the first, we'll convert it into frequency domain. So we put the capacitor as 1 over JC and the inductor as J omega L and 1 over J omega C. So this is 1 over J omega C, 1 over J omega L, and this should also have been the capital I and capital V. So there's a mistake here. And then, as we just mentioned, that for simplification, for J omega we will be writing S. So the circuit will become now S over 10 or S into 0.1, and this will become S2, and so we'll solve this circuit. So here is the circuit. We need to find this transfer function, voltage over current, so that means impedance. So this is the impedance that we need to find. So the transfer function is the impedance of this. So we'll just find the impedance of this branch, and you can see these two are in series. These two are in series, and then the both the branches are in parallel. So we'll this branch, which was in series, this one in parallel with the right branch, in parallel with the right branch, and we can then simplify. So this is the simplified form here, and from here we can find the this was the final answer, and now we need to find the second part, that is 0 and 1. So for 0 we put the denominators equal to 0. So if you put S plus 2 equals 0, we get Z1 is equal to minus 2. That is Z, we write S as Z for 0. And similarly, when this one is put equal to 0, S plus 1.5, then we get answer Z2 is equal to minus 1.5. This one goes other side, it will become minus. So these are the two zeros of the function, and for getting pole we have to put 0 of the denominator. So the denominator is put equal to 0, and since this is a quadratic equation, we will use the quadratic relation of finding the roots. So that means we have two roots, plus and minus. So for pole now we write P, so P1 and P2, it will be minus 2 plus minus J. So this is the answer. Another one, now in this case we have to find the current gains, current output divided by current input. Similar technique, convert into the polar form, frequency domain. So J omega 1 over J omega C, and then convert into S domain. So replace J omega by S. So this is the circuit we now need to find. Now we want to find the ratio of this current divided by the input current. So we need to find the current in this branch, and if you recall, we'll just use the CDR. So the current in this branch is the total current divided by the total resistance and multiplied by opposite arm. So multiply by opposite arm. So this is how we get the current. And now to find the transfer function, we take it to the left hand side. So this is our transfer function. By simplifying, this is the final result, and from here again we can find 0 by putting the numerator equal to 0, and we can find pole by putting the denominator equal to 0. So when we put this equal to 0, we have S equal to 0, that is our Z1, and from here we get S is equal to minus 2, that is Z2 is minus 2. So these are the two zeros, and similarly for the denominator, this can be written as S plus 1 square is equal to 0. So we have two roots of the same at the same place. So this is called repeated poles. S plus 1 is equal to 0, and S plus 1 is equal to 0 because of the square. So the repeated pole is at P is equal to minus 1. When we put this equal to 0, it will be P is equal to minus 1.